flies down to paradise. At least it's not foaming. If the wind is right, you can sail away and find tranquility. Oh, the canvas can do miracles. Just you wait and see. Never, never land, a reason to pretend.
and perhaps wiser now. We all show it in different ways. Our bodies have changed. Some of our hair has turned gray and some has turned loose. But it's been said that, you know, aging is not without its benefits. For example, there is very little left for us at this point to learn the hard way. Our supply of brain cells is finally down to a manageable size. We no longer think of speed limits as a challenge. Our joints have become more accurate meteorologists than James Spann. And our secrets are safe with our friends because they can't remember them anymore. Some of us have finally quit trying to hold our stomachs in, no matter who wants it. And we can actually sing along now with elevator music. And finally, we can have a party and the neighbors don't even notice. But perhaps the most important benefit of age and the passing of time is that it has a way of leveling things out, of focusing our attention on the things that really matter. Things like our faith and our family and our friends. There's less concern over competition, over who has the biggest salary or the biggest house or the biggest yacht or whose kids are Rhodes Scholars or tech company CEOs. And there's more concern about who is genuinely happy and fulfilled. At our age, you know, no one really remembers or cares about our grades or our awards or even our touchdowns. But we do remember simple acts of kindness. We remember what kind of person you were. And the most important thing is, what kind of person are you? What have you become from our shared foundation? And I believe that's where the class of 1970.
She's ready to go. All right, we're going to try again.